A very good morning to all of you. Today we will start. We will see some question based on the chapter function, and we will focus on built-in function. Okay. So first question is, which of the following function is a built-in function in Python? You can see here four option I have: seed, square root, factorial, and print. If you see seed come under the module random. Okay, square root and factorial both are come under the module of math. So they are not, we can not call these function as a built-in function. So built-in function in a Python is print, because print function which prints a value directly to the system output. So here answer will be a print. Next, what is the output of the expression round 4.576? As you all know, round is again a built-in function in a Python. So it will see that 4.5, after 5 the value is 4.5. So as you know, when we round up any number, so it will round up to the nearest one. Okay, like you can see here, jaise yahan par 4.5 hai, to 5 jab number aa raha hai to ye round off karega 5 ke side pe. Agar smaller than 5 hota, then it will round up 4. Okay, so answer will be here 5. Now next, the function power x, y, z is evaluated as, you know, whenever we want to calculate power of two number, is just very simple. You can write like this. Okay, wait, yeah, you will write like this: x power y. Fine. I will increase the font so it will be visible to you. Now you can see, if we have to write x power y, then it will written like this. But if we have three arguments, how we will write down if we have to calculate the power of three arguments? Here you can see x double star y. Is it is possible that we write like this? No, it is wrong, because our power argument says, if we have to, our power function says, if we have to calculate a power of three arguments, then we will write x double asterisk y and then the modulus sign. You can say percentage also. Okay, then you have to write percentage sign and the third argument. So this one is the correct if we have to calculate the power of three arguments. Now next question 4, what is the output of the function shown below? You can see here all is a function. Okay, yeah. Now you can see here that here all is a function, that is 2, 4, 0, 6. Now option are error, B option true, then C false, and the next one is 0. Okay, the option will come, the answer will come C, because here function returns value false if any one of the element of iterable is 0. If when we have to calculate with the all function, and inside that if any one of the element, any one of the item is 0, then it will return false value. And when it will return true value? If no element is 0. Okay, So here output will be a false. Now see, what is the output of the expression? Again the same question coming here, but here you can see the difference. Yeah, okay, we have to enlarge this question. Yeah, see here their value was 4.5, then 7, but here 6. Okay, the function here is used to round off the given decimal to specify decimal places. Here decimal places is mentioned over here, that is 2. So it will see here 6. Okay, the value of 6. Now after 6 the value is 7. So it will change the place of 6 here. Fine, because 7 is greater than 5, so if the 6 will get changed to 7. Here answer will be a 4.7. Round off karna, you all know, everyone know how to round off a number. So but here the difference is that the number, the place is given till which place we have to round off the number. Now come to the next question. The next question is, what is the output of the following function? Find any. Then 2 is greater than 8, 4 is greater than 2, and 1 is greater than 2. So any, if when we use any function, always you know any returns true or a false. Okay, if more of the element of iterable or non-zero, okay, then it will return true value. If there will be a zero element, it will return again a false value. Okay, so here we can see that no element is zero, so it will return the true value. Now next, come to the next question. What is the output of a function shown below? Import math abs, that is for use for absolute value, math dot square root. If we want to find out the square root of 25, you all know that the square root of 25 is 5. Okay, but before that we are using absolute value of the past argument. Fine, so as you all know, if we have to find absolute of any negative or a positive number, the value will come out positive. Okay, hence in this case we get here, we will get the square root of 25 is 5.0, and the absolute value of 5.0 will come 5.0. Now next question, what are the outcomes of function shown below? Here you can see sum is using, okay, 2, 4, 6, and sum here again 1, 2, 3. Now in this question, first function will result in an error, because this function will show you an error, because sum is used to find the sum of iterable numbers. Fine, hence the outcome will come, this is not a iterable number. If we use a square bracket instead of these bracket, then it becomes an element of sum. Okay, then it will give sum, but here it will give you an error. Fine, and this will get you from the second function, you will get the sum of numbers. So 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6. Hence you will get here the answer will be an error 6. From this you will get an error, and from this you will get output, that is 6. which next is your which. See here. Okay, next question is, what is the output of the function again all function is using? We are using again all function. Fine. Now you can see, what is the output of the function? Here again all function, and you know in all function when it will return true? If all element are non-zero, and return false if all element are false. If one of the element is zero. But here you will see that we need a square bracket also, because item will be iterable. Fine. That's why it will give you error here, because here square brackets are not used. That's why it will give you an error. Okay. When elements become iterable, if we use square bracket, then elements become iterable. Otherwise, they are considered as a non-iterable element. Now, next question is, what is the output shown below? Min, max, false, -3, -4, 2, and 7. Fine. Here you will get the value false. How? Because this function max is used to find the maximum value among -3 and -4. Fine. And false. So what's the maximum value is here? False. Since false amounts to the value 0. Fine. Here instead of false you can write down 0. Now the value become, if you see, minimum of 0, 2 and 7. Now which one is minimum value? 0. And the answer for 0 is false. Okay. Now next we will see more built-in function. We will see more built-in function. These are here. Okay. Yeah. First question over here is, what is the outcome of the following function if char 97 is given? Okay, it's showing what are the outcomes of following function char 97. The answer will be, if we type for a 97 is in a small, the sky value of capital A starts with 65. Okay, so and small a start with, the sky value of small a start with A. So here you will get an error. Why an error? Because you can see here char, then 97 is considered as a string. Fine. Here I am again repeating that which. Now next we will see. Okay, that char is a 97 is a sky value, but if we enter 97 in a single quote, it will be considered as a string. So it will just throw an error. Okay, function only char function will accept the integer value, but we are passing the string, so it will throw you an error. Next we will see, what is the output of the function complex I plus 2j? complex you already complex is a data type for number, complex number. Here you see, what are complex number? One is your real part. The number contain real and imaginary, both the parts, that is considered as a complex number. Fine. So the answer over here is simply the number itself, because it is a complex number. Fine. The built-in function complex return argument in a complex form itself. So output will be D here. Now next we will see, what is the output of the function complex? Which one? OJ, O plus, 0J, 0 plus 0J, 0, then error. Here answer will be a 0J, because if the real part is 0, that means nothing. Fine. So here complex number returns 0J if the both the arguments are omitted. That's why it's written simply this. Now next question. What is the function diff mode where both a and b are integers evaluated? Okay, so here you will see the function diff mode, that means division plus modulus. Fine, both the things you want. First you have to calculate division, then the modulus of a and b. In this we see that modulus is given first, so this is not our option. Now next come to, okay, division, it's okay. Next we will see it's a modulus, yeah. Then B will be an answer. Now what is the output of a function shown below? Div mode 10.5 divided by 5. So it's simply first calculate the division, then the modulus, and for second similarly, first it will calculate the division and modulus. Now if you see here, if you calculate, divide 10.5 divided by 5, so answer will come 2.0 and the modulus of this number will come 0.5. fine. And for second 2.0 and 0.0. now next, the function complex weight. The function complex 2 minus 3j is a valid, but the function complex, it's written in a single quotes against 2 space minus space 3j is invalid. State whether this statement is true or a false. Yes, it's true, because whenever we have to declare any complex number, we have to define any complex number. So in complex number, space does not be included. Okay, else it will be considered as not a complex number. Fine. Now, see, when converting from a string, the string. We must not contain any blank spaces around the plus or minus operator. Hence, the function complex will result in error. As I told you, don't include space. Now, see next question. What is the output of the function shown below? List. Here, list. Then, enumerate. What do you mean by enumerate? Enumerate. Accept an iterable as an argument. So you can see here list enumerable weight. Where it's gone? Okay. Oh yeah, it's come here. Yeah, you can see here that enumerate accept an iterable as an argument. The function shown is above case containing pair of numbers given starting from 0, and hence the output will be 0 to and 1, 3. You see, enumerate will 2, 3. Okay, it will go from start with 0 till 3. So 0 to 2 and 1 to 3. Fine. Now next question, what are the outcome of the function shown below? Here x is equals to 3, eval x power of 2. Now what will be the output? If 3 raised to is, if 3 XOR of 2, okay, here you will see the operator, it's AND, OR, NOR, XOR, which one is here. Fine, if you find out, you will get the output 1. How? Function eval is used to evaluate the expression that it takes place as an argument. In above cases, the eval function is used to perform XOR operation between 3 and 2. Hence, the output will come 1. Now, next. See, next question is, what is the output of a function shown below? Fine, its question is here, float 1e003. As you all know that in a float function we can include exponent also. It's a form, just a form that it can be written like that. Okay, 1e. So you have to do till the 3 places. It will have 0 till the 3 places. So 0.001. Okay. Now after, in this function it's saying plus. So after 2 you have to add. Fine. After 3, 0 you will add 0. And here minus, so before 1 you have to add, and here plus sign is here, so after that you will add. Fine. Now, so option come B. So today we will finish over here, and in next class we will evaluate more question and see how question comes in CBSE. So read each and every function in the chapter, read each and everything from the book and make notes of that, so it will be easy at the time of exam. Okay, so have a good day.